Do you like to read stories? Do you notice the elements or parts of the story when you are reading? Today, we'll talk about the three basic elements of a story. Story elements are the different parts of a story. The three basic elements are the characters, the setting, and the plot. The character is a person, animal, or sometimes even an object that takes part in the action. It answers the question who. The setting refers to the place and time in which the story happens, or where and when the story happens. The place can be a building, a country, or even a friend's house. The time can be in the past, present, or future. It can also be a time of day, a season, or a month in a year. Authors often use descriptions of landscape, scenery, buildings, atmosphere, or weather to provide a strong sense of setting. The plot is the sequence of events in a story. It consists of the beginning, the middle, and the ending. The beginning is the start of the story. The characters and setting are introduced in this part, as well as the problem faced by the main character. The middle presents the events and details about what happens to the characters, like the actions they made to solve the problem. The ending shows how the characters change or are different than they were at the beginning of the story. This part also gives solution to the problem. Now, we will read the story and try to identify its elements. In a field one summer's day, a grasshopper was hopping about, chirping and singing to its heart's content. An ant passed by, bearing along with great toil an ear of corn he was taking to the nest. "Why not come and chat with me," said the grasshopper, "instead of toiling and moiling in that way?" "I am helping to lay up food for the winter," said the ant, "and recommend you to do the same." "Why bother about winter?" said the grasshopper. "We have plenty of food at present." But the ant went on its way and continued its toil. When the winter came, the grasshopper had no food and found itself dying of hunger, while it saw the ants distributing every corn and grain they had collected in the summer. Then the grasshopper knew it is best to prepare for days of need. Who are the characters in the story? The characters are the ant and the grasshopper. What is the setting of the story? Where did the story take place? Correct, in a field. When did the story take place? The story happened one summer's day. We can also include winter, since a part of the story also took place when winter came. Some stories take place in two or more different time periods and places. What is the plot of the story? Let's discuss it part by part. First, what is the beginning of the plot or the story? This is when the setting was introduced, as well as the characters of the story. The grasshopper was singing while the ant was taking an ear of corn to the nest. The middle of the story would be when the grasshopper asked the ant to chat with him, but the ant refused. Why? Because the ant was preparing food for the winter. The ending of the story was when winter finally came and the grasshopper had no food while the ants were distributing the food they had collected in the summer. The grasshopper realized it is best to prepare for days of need. When analyzing a story in terms of its elements, you can also make use of a graphic organizer, such as a story map, if that helps you to organize your thoughts better. One of the simplest graphic organizers would be this. So to analyze the story that we studied earlier using this story map, we just have to put the setting here, the character or characters here, and the plot here. The first box under the plot would be for the beginning. The second box would be for the middle. And the last box would be for the ending. Have you tried to use graphic organizers before? Do you also think it is a good way to organize ideas? Let me know in the comment section below. That's all for today, and see you in the next lesson.